Dr. Banda Prakash ji.
Thank you, Chairman sir, for giving me the opportunity for speak on this bill. Sir, we support the bill. Sir, this bill, in the guidelines of the earlier, what our Honorable Minister said, India handled about 5 million gross tonnage, which is around 25% share of world ship recycling industry. The government plans to nearly double this by 2025-24. International Monetary Time Organization adopted Hong Kong International Convention on Safety and Environmental Sound Recycling Ships in 2009. Aim at ship being recycled do not pose any negative effects on environment and stakeholders and public at large, sir. Sir, in India, Gujarat yards handling around 400 ships in every year. Actually, the background of ships coming to our developing countries, particularly Bangladesh and Pakistan and India, almost all are developing countries. Japan, Korea and other countries also sending their ships to recycling in India. Most developed countries sending very developing countries. Why they are sending it to the India, we should think, sir. There may be the choice of dismantling location is often influenced by the price of metal a facility can offer to the ship owners. Second one, to make maximum profits, where pay and health and safety standards are minimal. Based on this, generally, they will take decisions in this manner, sir. Actually, even though we have accepted Hong Kong resolution, adopting that, according to European Community Commission report, the facilities in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh still have a long way to reach international standards to fulfill the minimum criteria to be awarded an A label. They have classified A, AA, and AAA. Three levels are there. Most advanced European Union Commission report, they are following AAA standards. But whereas even we have to reach A standards, it is a very long way according to that reports. There is a, the overview of the industry in these countries show that the process of ship dismantling remains manual. There is lack of management system to handle hazardous waste. Pollution prevention is not at present, and there is a little or no consideration of safety and fair condition towards workforce. Even Europe ships also, they are sending into our countries, sir. They are also recycling it in India. Actually, in India, the beaching method, besides the beaches, under the beaching method, ships are grounded and broken into unprotected marine environment. This method is unsafe to the workers, sir. Almost all international organizations, they have made studies on this. This is mostly unsafe methodology to go for such of the methodology, beaching method. Instead of that, that should be send it to the dry docks. There is no facilities, such facilities in India, sir. If we think of constructing dry docks in the particular areas, that will be more facilitate for more safer and good environmental free atmosphere in the country, sir. Sir, because this is more labor intensified area, I wish to bring it to the kind notice of the House that Honorable Minister also given an answer on 15-7-2009, sir. That is one of our member asked for whether the workers of the shipbreaking yards reported to be faced health hazards due to negligence in waste disposal of practices. No such report has been received. Our Honorable Minister is given such answer in the House of the House, sir. But almost all, in India, 80% of 400 majority 30% of the total recycled at done at Indian this one, sir. The ship breaking code also provides elaborated provision for safety and compliance, such as space and space patches, firefighting equipment, appointment qualified safety officers for supervision, and all facilities has been given. There is so many incidents is occurred in the even Gujarat port, sir. Some 470 workers have died in the accidents along and Sosoya since started demolition from 1983. The real number could be far higher because of deaths are under-reported since 1983. 4,000 fires have been broken out since 2001. 141 fatal accidents and 301 non-fatal ones have been taken place. The Along and Sosoya shipbreaking yards dismantled 6,604 vessels till 2014 and produced 3 million tons of the scrap metal annually, sir. This I bring it to the kind notice of the Honorable Minister, because so many people are they are facing the problem, sir. According to International Federation of Human Rights, IFHR, says that many risk of get handicapped on the spot because of the accidents like exposing due to ship tanks not freed from the gas, and accidents due to lack of safety measures. Others die slowly because of illness related to the toxic and marine material they are exposed to the whole day. Some cancer types and asbestos related disease will occur in 15 to 20 years later. Sir, kindly please take it into the consideration of all these things. It might be a very big breaking, might be having advantages, giving for employment and making some profits in this sector. But the ship breaking is conducted haphazardly with very little scientific and technical knowledge and inadequate environment. Health and safety standards and workforce could be exposed to a wide range of hazards, and the activities breaking should be leave a proportionality large environment footprints behind. Ship breaking practices in India are labor intensive, sir. Experienced basin management and not technically organized. Apart from major unorganized sector labor, thousands of migrant workers from the poorest of the part of such ship dismantling process, sir. The impact of the industry on environment related issue and worker safety and occupational health conditions seems to be underestimated or conservative in the bill, sir. Sir, the studies reveal that in ship recycling, India will become a dumping yard in case no specific provisions are made. Sir, in Indian context, the polluter pays principle is required to be properly addressed in the present proposed bill. The workers' safety measures are not adequately addressed in the bill, sir. In case of the floating, sir, concluding, sir, in the floating of the provisions proposed, the penalties proposed and are disproportionate to the benefits of on recycling, sir. Hence, penalties provisions may be rationally increased in case of defeating the provisions of this Act. Regulations and guidelines, etc., sir. On constitution and composition of the national authority and competent authority, the bill required incorporation of the stakeholders, particularly NGOs, research organizations, third party assessment holders, and even workers' representatives and other related persons to effective the implementation of safety and ship recycling and transparency, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.